If you were watching the broadcast last night, you saw Kerry Sanders profile the heroic efforts to find survivors beneath the collapse of a supermarket. And Kerry is with us again tonight with an encouraging update to that story, Kerry.
Well, Lester, at that supermarket, it is a slow-motion race, and we joined the search teams on their moment-by-moment, at times bare-hand dig for survivors.
8:53 a.m., a search team from Turkey gingerly looks for an entry point. At minimum, they try to create an air hole for the living. It was the height of the shopping day when the five-story supermarket collapsed. Inside, teams say there are signs of life.
I never gave up hope.
Fidel Amagrabi's sister-in-law was inside. He's held vigil here since the quake. He's weary but optimistic. Morel Dittmer is still alive.
I know that she's a fighter. She will live to go for her kids.
9:53 a.m., an American team joins the Turks. 33 members from the South Florida Urban Search and Rescue Task Force begin an assessment.
You go in one section, cover that area, and if they're not there, you have to go somewhere else.
With the help of blueprints, they build the structure backwards to see where air pockets have trapped survivors. From the roof, rescuers enter a hole, slither on their stomachs 5 feet to another hole, drop down, and create another hole.
Me and the other brothers worked for about 2.5 hours to get through about 12 inches of concrete.
It's slow, claustrophobic work in the dark.
It's a little nerve-wracking just to know that, you know, if there's any tremors or anything, things can change very quickly.
10:07 a.m., the American team says they can absolutely confirm two are still alive. They talk to a 17-year-old girl who says she is with a boy.
They're telling us right now that they're not hurt, they're not injured, they're just thirsty.
And that fear of tremors comes true. At 10:59 a.m., for 11 terrifying seconds, the ground shakes.
Keep on going, away from the pile.
17 minutes later, a frantic phone call.
That where we're digging, we're on the right track.
Cell phone signals penetrate the pancake debris, and text messages are relayed to the command post.
There's a bunch of people in the aisle with him.
They're alive.
They're fine.
There's how many people alive?
He said more than 60.
60?
Yes.
For 5 hours, the Americans and the Turks dig, while in South Florida, Muriel's son Richie and Mickey anxiously wait for news of their mother. Finally, a water truck arrives. Teams snake a hose down to the survivors. This rescue effort is now a symbol of Haiti's hope.
They're still digging at this hour. They expect to continue digging tomorrow. As for that area where those 60 people may be trapped in that void, they tried to phone back to the phone. Nobody answered. They could not get through. It is a horribly anxious night for family members on the outside waiting for news, and of course for those on the inside, desperate.
These are true heroes, these people who do this work. Kerry Sanders, thanks very much.